What is timing the market? It's the Nirvana, the Holy Grail, the mother of all stock investing. Because if you manage to sell right before the big crash and buy right before the big surge, if you manage to time the market perfectly, then you'll get perfect gains on your market. So let me get straight to the point of this video. How do you time the market perfectly? The answer is, you can't. Wait. What I mean is that you can't time the market using the noob way, which is selling right before the crash and buying right before the recovery. But you can time the market using the pro way, which I'll be sharing with you in this video. You may be new to the investing game, still in the tutorial area, or you might already have grinded the market for a few years and is now at level 50. Whatever it is, we are now facing the biggest boss of our time, the market crash of 2020. The noobs always think that they can time the market perfectly. But if you look it up, the god level NPCs have done it much longer than you. People like Warren Buffett, Peter Lynch, Benjamin Graham, John C. Bogle, and all of them have their own way of timing the market, also known as the pro way. So let's start. My name is Calvin, and today I'll be sharing with you why you can't use the noob way of timing the market, and I will use actual data to back it up, because science, and why you don't have to time the market. I also will be sharing with you how the god level NPCs like Warren Buffett have been timing the market. And at the end of the video, I'll be sharing with you my strategy of timing the market. Yes, I do time the market, but using the pro way. Each market crash was caused by different factors. For example, the crash of 1929 and the 2000 crash was caused by speculation bubble in stocks. The 2001 crash was caused by political risk after the September 11 attacks. The 2008 crash was caused by panics and speculation in the real estate. And the recent 2020 crash was caused by some virus named after a beer. Each time the crash happened, there was a different time frame, different amount of drops. In the most recent 2020 crash, it dealt extremely high damage to our portfolio's health bar, while all the past crash have dealt long and slow damage over time. And because each crash is different from one another, there is absolutely no way of telling how to time each crash perfectly. Why can't you time the market perfectly? Let's check out the better history of all the self-declared pros. Based on the research, 42 out of 68 self-declared pros were accurate less than 50% of the time. The best market timer have made accurate predictions only 68.2% of the time. I don't know about you, but if you were to get that kind of grade in an Asian family, there will be C at best, short for can't eat dinner. Let's look at another stats. CNBC reported that over a 1 year period, 64.5% of the active funds underperformed the market. And over a 15-year period, about 91% of active funds underperformed the market. A research by Dunbar found that from 1995 up to 2015, the market averaged about 10% a year, while the average equity fund investor earned only about 5.19%. Remember that these are not random people like you and I. These are professionals with Ivy League educations, tons of experience in the market, and doing investing as their main job. And all of them has more data and more sophisticated tools than all of us. And the fact that they are losing most of the time to the market, while the rest of us only have access to public news, stock price, and some occasional analyst who shouts market is crashing every once in a while. That's all we have really. And if all the pros, I mean self-declared pros, can't even time the market perfectly with all the tools that they have, what makes you think that we can do it? Timing the market comes with its own cost, called opportunity cost. JP Morgan, which is the investment banking company, which to us is just a high-level investment guild, found that if you were to be fully invested in the market from 1999 to 2018, the total return would be 5.62%. But let's say if you were to time the market and miss out on the 10 best days, your result would drop to 2% instead. And if you were to miss out 20 best days out of that 20-year period, your returns would actually be negative. If you are planning to time the market, that means you are looking for signs that the market is recovering, right? However, JP Morgan found that 6 of the 10 best days usually occurs within 2 weeks of the 10 worst days in the past. That means that if you were to time the market, you'll be missing out on the best days to gain maximum profit on the market. But here's why you actually don't have to time the market. Sharpe, another high-level investment guild, also did a study. The first thing I noticed about this study is that Sharp has very good humor and is very good at giving names to people. What the study found was that even if you had perfect timing, you will outperform a steady and consistent investor by only about 6%. And if you had incredibly bad timing like Rosie Rotten, your returns will actually drop by 12% compared to investing immediately. What this study tells us is that even if we had incredibly good timing, our reward wouldn't be as high as we think. And if we time the market wrongly, we will be missing out on a lot of gains. Just another study by Peter Lynch, another high-level legendary NPC. He once said that holding investments for the long term was the most effective strategy, and the price which you bought the share was not important. How long you held it was what mattered. What he meant in gamers' term is that you do not have to time your attacks and your stance perfectly. You just have to deal consistent, long, sustained damage over time to defeat the boss. And to prove his point, he also conducted a study. He found that timing the market perfectly versus investing consistently in the market, you will only earn an extra 12% profit, and not as much as you would like to think. Let's say your strategy was to time the market in 2008 and 2009 crash. The best time to enter the market was around March 2009. If you were to look at the data, the unemployment rate was still rising from 2009 all the way to 2010 January, and by which the market would have gone up a whole lot of 25%. And on top of that, don't forget that H1N1 started around April 2009. So that will be the true cost of trying to time the market in 2009. So let's talk about how our legendary NPC, Warren Buffett, is timing the market. Remember about all the advice of dollar cost averaging and investing immediately? Well, Warren Buffett isn't doing it. Otherwise, he wouldn't be sitting on about 130 billion cash. What he's doing is that he's only investing a small portion of his cash while waiting for the right time to invest a big pile. First, Warren Buffett identifies the companies which he likes using superior analytical ability. I won't be talking about it in this video because it's a whole tutorial on its own. But basically, he looks at return on equity, debt to equity, profit margin, and whether the company is cheap or not. And if the company is not at its intrinsic value, he just puts it in his wish list. Then he times the market by waiting patiently for the stock price to drop to its intrinsic level. Or in gamers' terms, he's reserving his mana while waiting for the defense of his enemy to drop. And when it drops, he dishes out a series of high damage combo attacks on his enemy, dealing the maximum damage possible. And that's why at the beginning of this crash, when the stock price of Delta Airlines dropped, Warren Buffett quickly bought the stock at a small amount of 45.3 million at a price of around 46.40. Just look at the price of Delta Airlines now. It has dropped even more. But do you think that legendary NPC cares? Not at all. He only cares about the long-term price of the stock, which he himself had mentioned in the 2-hour-long interview with CNBC early March. So, what is my strategy for this market crash? Well, it is more or less Warren Buffett's way, which is finding out the company which I like, putting it in my wish list, and waiting for the right price to buy. Right now, I'm sitting on almost 30% cash position, which is constantly increasing when my salary comes in. My plan is to set a target buying price, just like Warren Buffett. Then, when the stock drops to that price, I will just buy it immediately, because it's a price which I like. And by doing so, I won't be missing out on buying at the best price, in case the market recovers. And what if after I bought, the price goes down even more? Then I will just deploy even more cash. The worst feeling isn't so much about buying at the wrong price. The worst feeling is that when the market recovers 10%, 20%, 30% in a matter of days, and you realize that you have completely missed out on the best timing possible, that regret, that shame of missing out on the best timing, it will stay with you for a long while. Personally, I feel that the recovery of this crash would be extremely fast because on the day the investors finally realized that the stock price are extremely cheap and it has been oversold, it will shoot up so fast that you will not even have the time to react to it. So my advice to you is that don't try to time the market and end up on missing out on the best opportunities of your lifetime because chances like this are extremely rare. So that's all for today. Let me know down in the comments below, what stocks are you looking out to buy, or what is your strategy in timing the market? like, share, and subscribe, as I'll be posting new videos every Monday. See ya!